Welcome to Top 5 Wednesday, and this week's topic is books that deal with hard subject matter.
So this was actually a fairly easy book list to come up with.
Yeah, surprisingly.
And we got a diverse range of topics.
Yeah.
There is not a repeat. First on our list is the one that came to mind very quickly, Knots and Crosses, which deals with racism.
Yes.
This is weirdly a book that throws racism in your face.
Mm-hmm.
But it doesn't, it's enjoyable.
Yeah. Kind of like a Romeo and Juliet retelling. Kinda.
Yeah, no, at its very essence, it definitely is. But you've also got, like, these underground sleeper groups that are, like, terrorist groups who are kind of fighting for equal rights. They switch the races roles, so you have black people in power and white people being oppressed, which kind of, like, blows your mind because you don't realize it for the longest time. And then they're like, hey, yeah, this is what's going on.
I really like the first book.
Me too.
And it kind of gets more kind of like soap opera-y as you like progress down the trilogy, which turns out to be a quartet because there's another one coming out.
Oh god, no.
But yeah, like...
Read the first one.
The first one is solid. I cried.
I did too.
Next on our list is Go Ask Alice by Anonymous. And when we both read this, it was intense. Like, holy shit. Because when you're reading it, you... Like, it's presented that it is an actual diary. And for, like, a long time, everyone thought that it was an actual diary. Kind of came out in, like, the last 10 years that it was forged, it's not real, but still the message behind it's pretty solid, like, you know, anti-drug.
And especially if you're, like, 12 years old, because you have no sense of reality and... questioning whether it's a real thing.
It will scare you straight. Like, you know, like, I will never touch drugs! You know, that kind of thing.
Looking back on it now, it's a little overdone.
It's a little overdone, it's kind of preachy, but you know, it made me feel things when I was a kid, and it made me feel things enough that when I had to choose a book with, like, hard subject matter to adapt in high school, that's what I chose.
So I don't know how you'd feel about it reading it now, but
yeah,
if you have like a kid who wants to read something really hardcore, this would be it.
And there are multiple ones now. Like, they've released other diaries in the vein of Go Ask Alice.
I have no desire to read them. But it was good back in the day. Next on our list is Bumped, and this one deals with teen pregnancy. And it doesn't deal with teen pregnancy in the way you think it would deal with teen pregnancy, which is like, oh, teen pregnancy, difficult, blah, blah, blah. No. It takes teen pregnancy and it puts it in context of, like, a futuristic world where, you know, the birth rates have declined except for people, I think, like, under the age of 20 or something like that. There's, like, a very narrow window where people can have babies, so, you know, it's very popular for girls to go have a kid, maybe get sponsored and get a lot of money from having babies. And so it's just kind of like... looking at the way that we treat women and sex and how it can be unhealthy. And it was fun and, like, you know, kind of campy at the same time. But it did deal with kind of a very dicey subject matter.
Mm-hmm. Next on our list is When a Monster Calls by Patrick Ness. And this book royally messed with me. And I think it was just the time that I read it, because this book deals with a kid whose mother is dying of cancer. And just how he's internalizing everything, because this kid, you know, he wants his mom to live, but at the same time, he can't deal with her suffering. And he kind of wants her to die, because he wants it to be over. And I read this book when my grandmother became really, really ill. And it was the last 4 months of her life. And so, it was really hard. And I think it dealt with that kind of, like, emotional grief really, really well and presented it in a really good manner, because how this kid deals with it is he kind of creates this monster who comes and tells him a story every night to teach him a lesson, and the lessons that he learns aren't easy. And so I cried my eyes out. And it's being adapted into a movie. Liam Neeson is going to be the voice of the monster, and I don't know if I'm actually going to be able to watch it. It's a good way to understand grief.
Yeah, and sometimes it's very hard to find a book that does that.
Yeah.
Last book on our list is The Ocean at the End of the Lane by Neil Gaiman. And it's kind of weird to say that it deals with hard subject matter in that it deals with what it's like to grow up and how you relate to your childhood, when a lot of books technically do that. But this one kind of felt like it was dealing with it in a way that was very serious and not just like a, oh, you grew up kind of way.
It manages to kind of capture that tragedy of the loss of innocence and how you kind of, as time goes by, you lose the awareness of what it was like to be innocent. You know, like, you realize that it's something you can't gain back, but at the same time, you don't even remember what it was like before.
It really gets across the sense of loss, I guess.
Yeah.
You're losing something that you're never going to get back. And I guess a lot of books do it, but this one seems to do it in a way that...
It's very personal.
Mm-hmm. You feel like you've lost something by the end of getting mm-hmm. through this book, not just the character. I don't really... There's not a very good, easy way to describe it.
No.
I think that's what makes it so good, is you mm-hmm. kind of come out of it and you have to really sit there and think about what you just read.
And how it affects you personally. Like, what you, like, focus on.
And you could probably come back to it a few years later and come out completely with something new, so...
It's something that I'm kind of planning on rereading this summer.
Yeah, that'd be good.
Because, like, I read it when I was still in university and kind of near the end of my university. And, like, my whole life is before me. And, like, so it was kind of like that feeling again, like, I don't know what to do.
Yeah, you know? You're just standing there like,
You're lost.
Yeah. I read it last year, so I'll read it 2 or 3 years down the road and probably bawl my eyes out. But yeah, so that's another good one where if you're feeling like a serious grown-up, it's something to read. So that was our list of books that deal with hard subject matter.
What are books that stand out to you that deal with subject matter, whether it be like overarching concepts or something that's very personal? Tell us about it in the comments below.
We'll see you later, guys.